But first, I want to talk about this issue of this drug, this hydroxychloroquine. Gosh, I'm always now the whole nation knows how to pronounce it except for me. And the issue, the issue of the shortage, how we're going to make more of these, is it effective? Our next guest knows a lot about this. Lili Gil Valletta, who is the spokesperson for Bright Path Labs and the CEO of CN Plus. A pharmaceutical industry or perhaps a startup that might be working on this. Lili, welcome to Breitbart News Tonight.
Hi, Rebecca. Thanks for having me.
So, Lili, you know, one of the things that we've talked a great deal about on this show is our China's monopoly on the generic pharmaceuticals that we need, including the active pharmaceutical ingredients, those raw materials that go into making our generic drugs. And so much of it, like 80% of it reportedly, comes out of China. So we're in this situation where we can't even make these drugs that we need in a pandemic. And from what I understand, your company is looking to ramp up advanced manufacturing of pharmaceuticals in our country. Do I have that correct?
That is exactly right. And it's ironic how a pandemic actually exposed that we not only needed to care for people's health, but also for our supply chain's health. And you're absolutely right. China and India have about 80% of those key components that go into American drugs. But to be more specific for our listeners, like 95% of ibuprofen comes from China. 90% of U.S. antibiotics come from China. So what we're seeing now is this horrible situation forcing us to rethink and reimagine what globalization really means and how we reclaim medicine independence here right at home. And that's exactly what Bright Path Labs and our team is looking forward to doing with a very unique technology that the FDA Emerging Technologies team already vetted and qualified as a promising new way for making manufacturing medicines in the U.S. So it's about time, and it's unfortunate it took a pandemic for us to reassess the supply chain.
Well, tell us about this this new method that you were mentioning. What is this?
So yeah, just for in layman's terms, drug manufacturing happens in a batch process. So what that means is you have a big infrastructure. Usually it's a sequential step-by-step process that is what it takes for the reaction of a chemical to happen. Now, this, of course, takes a lot of infrastructure and a lot of steps, and it's hard to reconfigure. So if you have one manufacturing line that is designed for making X, you cannot just very quickly reconfigure it and change it to make something else. Like it's very controlled, it needs to be regulated, et cetera. Now, Brightpath has a reactor. So imagine one machine that is able to do in one or a few steps what it will take multiple steps of a batch manufacturing process to do. So all of a sudden you're compressing into minutes what could take days. Now, of course, this process hasn't been scaled, because to this day, Brightpath has been focusing on creating medicines for rare diseases or orphan drugs that typically are not produced in mass because there may not be enough patients for this particular drug. But now we've actually been in conversations with people at the White House already to be part of the solution. And I think it's the time for American ingenuity to shine at a time like this and show that we can indeed reclaim that independence. We're dependent on a big infrastructure, the batch manufacturing that got us in this trouble and got shipped out to China because it was cheaper, maybe more cost effective, and now we're paying for it.
So this is fascinating. Now, in order to do this type of thing, I imagine that you need some certainty because a lot, I've heard again and again that this area, generic drugs, the margin is so small. Mm-hmm. And China has dumped so much on the market to drive out competition. How can you, do you need an initial investment, like a purchasing order essentially from the U.S. government to kickstart this? How are you guys able to kickstart this?
Well, that is a great question. And of course, anything right now that is a request from the U.S. government will immediately accelerate Brightpath's ability to scale. We have done the models and already contacted everyone that we would need to make this happen. And the minute we have that, whether it is a purchase order or a grant from a local or a federal, you know, agency, this can happen fairly quickly and easily at a 1/5 or even 1/10 of the cost that of what it would take to bring a manufacturing line in the traditional way right here in the United States. So the right conversations are happening, and I'm happy to report that there's been a lot of support and an uptake with the conversations we've had with folks from FEMA and DHS and others at the White House. And we're just kind of patiently and impatiently waiting to see how that can move faster. But because stockpiling is not the solution, and hydroxychloroquine feels like it's a promising solution, but this is not just about that. This is, how do we create a new infrastructure with technologies that are advanced and leading edge? This slow manufacturing process will allow us to quickly reconfigure the reactor for it to not only make hydroxychloroquine, but other life-saving medicines, and maybe start reclaiming that, you know, independence that we need for our medicine.
Well, let me ask you also, I mean, you're an American company, I'm assuming, and where are you guys based?
It's based out of New Mexico, but many of us are based in different places. Like, I'm based in New York City. I'm a former pharma executive myself, and there's a couple of other team members that are scattered throughout the United States. So, but the base, home base is New Mexico.
And you would be essentially, I mean, if you were given this grant, obviously starting with, you know, whatever we need for this pandemic, but going forward, you could essentially manufacture anything, any sort of need that we have quickly?
That's exactly right. And it actually gave me the chills the other day in a conversation with someone in the government. This could become a way for us to have medicine reserves. You know how we have oil reserves, and of course for national security purposes, there's many other things that we you know, have readily available. Well, stockpiling is not the solution for medicine, so having a way to manufacture with agility gives us those reserves. So you're absolutely right, that's a great question and point. The whole purpose here is starting with COVID-19 and the crisis and the shortages ahead, but also being ready for that ability to produce our own reserve, so to speak, of medicines when needed. So it's very exciting. We never thought that a pandemic was going to be what would put Brightpath Labs on the map. But I don't think this is just about us. This is just about reimagining how we solve for this mess that we're in, that has us so codependent on the outside world, in this case, to save lives.
You know, how many, and just for, I know our listeners would probably find this fascinating, how many jobs does that create for, you know, graduates, I'm sure people who study.
Oh my God.
How many jobs would something like BrightPath's, you know, proposal here create in the United States for American graduates, American chemists, American bio, you know, engineers and all of that?
Yeah, well, you know what? You just gave me a great piece of homework. I wish I had that number pinned down, right? But this is what I can tell you, and we can speculate what the answer is. These BrightPath reactors, because we are not a pharma company like, you know, the Bayers, J&Js, Novartis of the world that you kind of have to work in there to do the magic. In this case, our vision is, how do we democratize the knowledge in the usage of these reactors so they can live inside academic institutions? So that way, to your point, we are not only creating these medicine reserves and independence, but fueling the pipeline of researchers of the future and creating the jobs and bringing them home and investing in the talent and brain power of our people to make this happen. So I am going to take you up on that question because we can model it out. Honestly, it depends on how quickly we're able to take, you know, to really scale these numbers of reactors in different sites. All you need is a very small space that is what is called CGMP certified. So it's basically certified for manufacturing of pharmaceuticals. But an academic institution could be a space like that, which is what makes this so exciting.
And I mean, essentially, they would be using your patented technology here in these different environments. Do I have that right?
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. And our vision, once again, is to kind of democratize the usage of this, kind of like many other things have been, you know, reinvented. This is just accelerating and putting it in the hands of more people and more places. And making people realize at a time like this that we do not need to be dependent. It's just, again, activating American ingenuity so that we use our brain power here to create a better, you know, process that gets us out of the codependency.
Would this also, this process be able to create large amounts of the active pharmaceutical ingredients that go into other drugs?
That's exactly right, Rick. Yeah, but it's the reaction, right? The chemistry that goes with different APIs, these active ingredients that go into medications. Because compacting them as pills or capsules, that's easy. It's the active ingredient, what we are depending on from China, India, and others. So you're absolutely right. This is a modular solution that once you have the reactor, changing that chemistry or what goes into the formula, it's scalable, it's nimble, it's cost effective, hence giving us the ability to adjust based on need and not have a huge capital expenditure on a building that only makes one thing.
So has this been FDA approved, this whole process, or would it have to be still?
Yes. Yes.
It has been?
That's
or
exciting.
It's been approved?
Yeah, yes, here's the crazy kind of providential alignment of the stars. Earlier this year, BrightPath actually had a meeting with the FDA's emerging technologies team. So, you know, you can just search it, Google it. But the emerging technologies team is specifically designed at the FDA to identify leading edge technologies for drug manufacturing, for example. So BrightPath already passed the test of all that vetting and what it takes to be admitted as a promising technology by the FDA's emerging technologies team. Also, earlier this year, the FDA has written out the guidelines for how is it that you do advanced drug manufacturing with this kind of process in a way that is compliant, efficient, and of course passes all the marks of quality, efficacy that you need for making pharmaceuticals. So once again, we couldn't have planned this because this is just the way life has happened in the pandemic. But all of this happened before we were even talking about hydroxychloroquine. So there is that support right there. Now it's a matter of scaling it and scaling it as fast as we can. And that is where a lot of different people from the government, public, private sector are very interested in this work. FDA definitely gave us that like check mark of yes, move on. This is promising. Let's go earlier this year. So that's very exciting for the team.
It's amazing. Now, okay, and we're talking with Lili Gill Valletta, who's a spokesperson for BrightPath Labs. Now, so Lili, final question here. If you are given a big order from the mm-hmm. government to ramp up the production of this particular drug, hydroxychloroquine, mm-hmm. how long would it take for you guys to actually get it into high gear and make it? Make a bunch of batches.
I love that question. We've had all of our engineers running the models. Of course, with the acceleration of the U.S. government, it could be done as quickly as within 6 to 10 weeks for mass manufacturing, multiple reactors running, you know, in their full capacity. We couldn't really do that at scale with any other process. And that's the reason why, for those that are listening, that the reason why we're stockpiling. You hear the president talk about 29 million tablets that we have, you know, that FEMA is stockpiling. Well, it takes about 30 tablets per person, depending on the dosages, to have a full treatment of hydroxychloroquine in the way it's being kind of tried. So that allows us to treat 1 million people let's say, rounding it up, 29 million tablets, right? And unfortunately, we are seeing numbers that show that anywhere between 70 to 150 million Americans are going to get this virus within this year. So we definitely need to figure out a way to up production, because stockpiling is probably going to get us to treat about a million people. There's a lot more, about a 10x. So
six to 10 weeks for how many? Yes. 6 to 10 weeks for how many could you produce in 6 to 10 weeks? Or is that just 6 to 10 weeks to get started?
It's a factor of the how many reactors are turned on, right? So you're asking such great questions that I wish I could, you know, on a radio interview, project you an Excel file that shows you how our team has really modeled this out. But just to kind of put it in layman's terms for those listening, so one reactor is able to produce enough for the treatment of about 500,000 patients. So we like to talk in treatment terms because that's about 16 million tablets. But if I do the math of the 30 per patient, it gives me a better read of how many lives I can really touch. So, yeah, you can have one of these big reactors producing about 16 million tablets. And then the model goes from there, right? For everyone you add, it becomes more efficient. So you can have 5, you can have 10, you can have 15. And arguably fill the gap just with this technology, but I'm sure pharma is going to keep on donating, et cetera. Our goal is not that we're just the sole source of this. Our goal is, how do we turn to innovation and technology to be part of the longer term solution? But that's about the math. One reactor gets you about 16 million tablets.
And you can get your whole project up, at least for one reactor, up in about 6 to 10 weeks.
Yes, definitely.
And you know, it seems to me, and I'll give you the final word on this, Lili, before we let you go. It seems to me that this would be incredibly useful technology and useful, innovation to have when we come, mm-hmm. when we have shortages of drugs, because we have these shortages all the time of our generic drugs.
Yeah.
And
all the time.
Now, and it seems as if your company is perfectly suited to be able to supply these things quickly and, mm-hmm. And in a manner that, this technology could actually service all sorts of needs. And I'm assuming, but you tell me, that this is actually doing it this way is actually much cheaper than these giant, pill factories in India.
Exactly. It is cheaper. So the argument that got us in this mess to begin with, of cost and efficiency that arguably comes from offshoring, that myth kind of gets debunked with just doing it in a different way. But once again, what's exciting to us is that besides, to your point, hydroxychloroquine, this is not only a solution for shortages, but also for medicine access to remote places, to rural areas, because we're already seeing lupus patients that are not getting their supply of hydroxychloroquine because everybody's kind of like piling it up for COVID-19 patients. So you're robbing Peter to pay Paul in this case. But in addition to that, it gives me great hope, and there's already conversations we're having with folks at the medical school at Stanford, for example. There's so many brilliant American scientists that are coming up with real solutions to rare diseases that may never get commercialized as a treatment or as a pill because maybe it's for a small quantity of cases, but there's still human lives that are worth saving. So we want to also plug ourselves into that solution of you don't need to invest in a big infrastructure. If there's a rare disease that is going to save 50,000 kids with a rare disease that we can create the chemistry for in a bypass reactor, then let's do it. And that's why so many academic researchers are excited to be teaming up with us as well.
Hey, you know what? I want to thank you so much, Lili Gill Valletta, who is the spokesperson for Bright Path Labs and CEO of CN Plus, for explaining this. This is just really exciting technology. And, we wish you all the best, and I hope you get working because we need you to get going on all of this stuff. Thank you so much for joining us this evening.